in the 19-teens, Max Weber presented two different lectures, one on the vocation of science or the academic vocation, and the other on the vocation of politics. And one of his central claims was that each vocation was driven by a different will, the will to power in the case of politics and the will to truth in the case of academics. And so one of the conclusions that Weber draws is that it's very difficult for someone to cross the gap between these two vocations. We were prompted to reconsider this theoretical question in light of the recent turn to post-truth politics, where quite famously, Michael Gove said that the public was sick enough of experts already. And so it's been a question now of whether or not with the rise of post-truth politics and fake news and all these other different forms of information, if there's any more space for academic knowledge and expertise to make any kind of change in the political arena.
Because we were using Weber, we thought we would use his interpretive method. So to try and understand how political actors, or academics rather, who'd become political actors, engaged with politics, we focused primarily on their reflections of why they entered politics and what it was like doing the job of politics.
We looked at four prominent liberal arts or social scientists who'd made their way into politics and their recent memoirs or autobiographies. And so they were Elizabeth Warren, Fighting Chance. We looked at Michael Ignatieff's Fire and Ashes, Pablo Iglesias's Politics in a Time of Crisis, and we looked at Yanis Varoufakis's Adults in the Room. And through careful reading of all of these memoirs, we established really that, well, two of the actors, Varoufakis and Ignatieff, were really failures in politics. They really struggled to come to terms with the world of politics and its differences to the world of academia that they were used to. Warren and Iglesias have been more successful, but even for them, it has been noticeably a real struggle. It seems that there's an inevitable trade-off between speaking the truth and having access to power. And there are these ongoing tensions between the life of the scholar and the life of the politician. And it is possible to sort of weld the will to truth and the will to power, but it really takes constant, dedicated effort, which we hypothesize probably most social scientists and liberal arts professors don't necessarily possess.